Hello, good evening. My name is Kirby, and today we'll be talking about string bending. You'll be discussing what string bending is, how you do string bending, and where it can be used, and maybe some tips on how to maximize or how to enjoy more string bending. I'm going to separate these lessons into different sections so we can, you know, maximize each video for each part. Okay, you will start with the simple bending. Okay, to do simple bending, first, string bending is also called, you know, vibrato. Okay, meaning vibrate. So when you say vibrate, well, literally a string is already vibrating when you're strumming it, but you're going to make it vibrate in a way that you can hear the effect. I'll show you anyway. So if you're going to pluck the string, and then you're going to use your wrist to swing action like this while you're holding the string. So if you look at my wrist, it's doing this you know, twitching action. It's easier than doing like this one because you're positioning your hand on the fret, on the neck, and then you're just like bending it this way, so like this. So when you're bending the string, see? So when you're going to do some sort of guitar solo, you're gonna, it's nice to do some string bending at the end of, you know, long notes. So like, so that's the one of the basic types of string bending or vibrato. So, depending on the song that you're playing, if you're playing a very fast song, you know, or maybe some like a sexy song, you know, so you have to get a grasp of the feel of the song so you wouldn't misplace the string bending on what type of song. If the song is too fast and then you're bending it slow, you know, you have to keep in pace with the tempo of the song so you can get the feel of having an expression using string bending. Okay, now one other application of string bending is changing the pitch, because if you're bending the string, you're actually making the string tighter, and if you're making the string tighter while, you know, if you have a string, for example, if I have this string, and if you're vibrating the string, I don't know if you can see this. And then if I pull it tighter, it will vibrate, you know, faster, whatever. And in turn, it will make the pitch higher. So if I pluck the string, that's the normal sound. That's a E note. If I bend the string, it gives me a higher pitch. Normally, on a regular guitar or electric guitar or whatever, you can bend the string and produce the note two semitones, one or two semitones higher. So, for example, if I'm doing the E note, and then I'm bending it half, like a semitone louder, So it's this one. See? This is the F note. This is the E note. But if I bend the E note a little bit, I get the F note. See? Although you're gonna hear it, you know, like slowly changing pitch, like you know, like. So instead of having a note abruptly changing from E to F, you can do it more in a stylish way, like. So there's the like a smooth change of notes. Instead of hitting the note, like for example, if I want to hit the F note on the first try, so giving it a pluck right away, so it's hard. But if I start with the E note here, but quickly bending the string to get the F note, so I get the this slowly, well, this smooth progression from the E to the F. Okay. It adds a little style and more expressive way of doing the note. If I want to get the F sharp note, just two semitones from E, F, and F sharp. I'll be bending the string more. So from this one, I'll get the F sharp. I'll bend the string quite more. I almost get the correct note, but the problem is if you can't, you know, you need to practice a lot if you know you're going to hit that note, because getting the right note while bending the string will need a lot of practice, because you know, you might not get the exact note whenever just blindly bending. Unless your ears are very sharp and you hear the note when it arrives, but if you really need to practice so you can land on the exact note that you're looking for. So if you want to go for that F sharp, you really need to practice and memorize the bend. So that's two. That's the vibrato. And then the bending of the string to get the higher pitch. You can combine the two, so you can get the. So you can, for example, you get the. You have a solo with two notes from higher to lower. For example, from F sharp to E. This is how you do it normally. But if you have a string bending style, you can add a little flavor to it by doing this, like. So you hit the F note, F sharp note by bending the string, and then just pull it back down, and then pluck it again with the other pluck. If you're lucky and your string is nice and you can pluck it good, you only need to pluck once, so it'll sound like. So from going to the F sharp, going down, and doing a vibrato, so you actually did 1, 2, 3 and then little notes in one pluck, so. Okay, that's it for this part, and we will do another type. Next lesson, we're going to do a unison bending on the next video. So, see you next time, and thank you very much.